In this video, I'm going to show you 5 different architectural options you have when you're creating your own Google Chat apps. Hi, I'm Chanel, a developer advocate at Google. If you're curious how you can start building Google Chat apps, this video walks you through the different architectural options you have and how to best pick one. This is the first of a series of 3 videos that cover the anatomy of Google Chat apps. A Google Chat app is made up of 2 separate parts: the Chat App service, which is part of Google Chat itself, and the Chat App's logic. In this video, we will use the term Google Chat and Chat App, or simply app, to differentiate the two. The app logic needs to be implemented in your code, and you can use whatever libraries, tech stack, or services work best for your app. One of the most common ways that chat apps are implemented is by using web services or HTTP implementations. With this architectural approach, you can configure Google Chat to integrate with a remote service via HTTP. The logic of a chat app can run on an on-premise server or on a serverless execution environment like Google Cloud Function. Choosing a web service implementation allows you to make use of existing libraries and components that you use on your system. This architectural option is best suited for most of the Google Chat app use cases, specifically for those publicly available on the Google Workspace Marketplace. Creating your chat app's logic entirely in AppScript is a good option for speed and simplicity. AppScript being native to Google Workspace also means that authentication is handled automatically. This makes reading and writing data to Google Sheets, Gmail, Google Drive, and so on very easy. Since AppScript is native to Google Workspace, there's no additional cost to hosting your chat app's logic in the cloud. This architecture is best for chat apps built for your own domain. If the chat app implementation resides behind the firewall, Google Chat may be unable to make HTTP requests to it. One way to deal with this is to use Google Cloud PubSub. The chat app logic subscribes to a topic that carries messages from Google Chat. With this architecture, the chat app still must use HTTP to send messages to Google Chat. You can use Dialogflow endpoints to integrate your chat app with. Dialogflow uses natural language processing to determine what the user of your chat app is asking for. This is a great way to engage your users and help them to just chat naturally with your app without them having to learn any specific commands. It also means that you, as the developer, don't have to take into consideration every possible combination of words and terms to respond back to. With webhooks, you can send asynchronous messages into Google Chat from applications that aren't chat apps. Webhooks are only for the Google Chat spaces where they were added to, and they do not allow user interaction. This chat space hard coding means that you can neither share your chat app nor publish it on the Google Workspace Marketplace. Incoming webhooks are best suited for simple alerts to notify, for example, on-call personnel when a server goes down. So, which of the 5 architectural options is the best? Well, that depends on a number of things. When choosing a surface architecture, ask yourself, who is the chat app for? What resources will the app be accessing? And what type of conversational patterns do you want to implement? Let's say you're building a vacation planner chat app for you and your team of 5. You want your chat app to programmatically access the calendar of all of the team members. For such an app, I think choosing AppScript for your chat app's logic is a good choice, because it's easy to integrate with Google Calendar, especially in terms of auth. On to a second example. Let's say you were building a financial analytics chat app and wanted to monetize it. To make your chat app publicly available, you would have to publish it on the Google Workspace Marketplace. For such an app, I would look to use the web service implementation with something like Google Cloud Functions. This approach allows you to scale your app seamlessly as it spans across a multitude of Google Workspace domains. You also want to think about how your chat app is going to interact with people. I'm going to show you three different conversational patterns that you might want to implement. With synchronous messaging, the chat app responds to messages from users on a one-to-one basis. If the user messages to the chat app, it will respond with an appropriate message. An asynchronous conversational pattern is two-way communication between the user and the chat app, with the chat app sending any number of additional messages. For example, the user requests the chat app to start monitoring traffic on a network. The app sends an initial reply to acknowledge the request. Then the app later sends one or more messages reporting on the traffic monitoring request. An alert chat app that sends messages to a chat space uses the one-way from app pattern. Not all service architectures support all of the different conversational patterns that we just saw. In this screen, you see a grouping of the service architectures by conversational patterns. We covered the most common implementation architectures in this video. About which architecture would you like to see an in-depth video? Let us know in the comments section below. Want to learn more about Google Chat apps? Then check out the Google Chat for Developers documentation linked in the description. There you will find easy to follow along samples to get you started building your own Google Chat apps. Subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos about Google Workspace development and AppSheet. Stay tuned for future videos where I share more about building Google Chat apps.